Hello guys, how are you all? So this is the part 3 of uploading any file type to Firebase storage and real-time database, how we can get the reference from Firebase real-time database into our application. So we had done till where we were uploading file to storage and put that in real-time database. So now what we have to do is, let's create a JuiceFact function imported from Rect. Then inside that, what we need to do is, let's create a subscriber here. We can say const on child added. We can say on child added. It means something is, if we are adding something to the database, that's why I just named it as on child added. Database dot ref, what was the name? All files. Okay. Dot on. We know dot on function automatically triggers when something is changed in the database in reference, like in case of this, we have all files. If something is changed under that all files reference, it will automatically trigger. We need to add child added, because every time we will add new file, it means child added to that reference. Okay, so that's why I use that. Now snapshot will be here, then like that we will get snapshot here, snapshot dot value. We will check this in console, and also on JuiceFact return, what we have to do is, we just remove that subscriber which we added above ref, all files. We need to off it now. It's on here. We need to off it here. What was that? Child added. Okay. And the subscriber is on child added. We need to pass that here. Now save it out. Okay, let's see what's in the console now. Here is one file we uploaded. Now go to here. Upload this file now. Let's see if that's triggered or not. You can see it's triggered. We uploaded that file and we are getting that snapshot here. File name, file type, file URL from our real-time database. This. We have two files now. Okay. Now, how we can bind that snapshot in our list item? For that, just go to top here, just create a state, let's say files, set files, and juice state empty, and empty array. I just declared it. Or we can say it file list. Yep, set file list, files, files list. Yes. Okay, now what we have to do is, inside this we need to push that snapshot to the state which we just declared. Okay, so how we can do that? First of all, we need to do a declare new array, let's say helper array, a blank array, save it. Then helper array dot push, what we need to push inside that? Just say snapshot dot value function, just post. Okay, now we have state set files list, and inside that we need to push that helper array like this. This will be our previous files, and this is our new array now. Files is previous array, helper array is new array. We are merging two arrays here. You can see helper array into files, save it out. Now go to here, just do one thing, files dot file list dot map item and index, and inside that save it out. We are mapping now the file list array from our state from here. Okay, here we are setting file list to our state like this, and here we are getting file list from state. Let's check. It is saying four files are there. Let's try to save it again. Now you can see it's six, because we are using debugging here, it's not release build, so that's why we need to add one thing here. It is only for development time. We need to add this set files list as blank here. Let me show. Like this. This is only for development type. Okay. This. Now you can see. Now I am trying to save. We are seeing two files only. So inside item we know we have a item dot file name. Yes, you can see it's binding now. Save it. Now let's try to upload any file here like this again. It should be third one. Yeah, you can see that's binded over there. You can set loader in middle of that time where when it's trying to upload to the storage, you can set a loader type thing or whatever you want. So let me try to upload a file again, like sample PDF, and let me check this also here. You can see new file added there, and also it should be in all files here. Let me save it out. So I'll refresh it. You can see two files are there. So you can see four files are there now. Okay. Now, okay. Now, how we can preview that files in React Native component? So for that, we have to create a new file here. Let's say file preview.js, and inside that we need to import this. That's important. We can say file preview export default file preview. Save it out. And now go to app.js, copy file preview. And copy it out and add it to file I imported it. You can see I imported it from that file. Just save it out. Now close this. Okay. Now what we have to do is move this file and this file also. Now inside that we need to get the files details from previous page. It means from file upload page. So inside file upload we need to pass parameters to file preview file. So what we have to do is I think we can remove that list. Okay. Yeah, working. So inside this list item on press, we have to do a thing like arrow function here. Props. You must have props inside this file upload. This I have props, so that's why it will work. Props navigation dot navigate to file upload. Let me check if it's uploading or not. Save it out. Clicked. No, it's not going to that file. Why it's not file preview? Sorry, it's file preview. File preview. Saved it out. Click. Nothing inside that because we have nothing here. Let's say return view for now. Okay, saved it up. Okay, we are moving to that page. Now, what we have to do is we need to pass parameters with this file. How we can pass? Save. File data with this item. We are passing like that. And one thing important, set key to as index. Yeah. Now save it out. And how we can get this into our file preview page? So like that. Inside this, just create root. You can check React navigation document for this, how we can get parameters. So now go to file preview. It should be under curly braces like this. Now let's try to do console.log root. Okay, we are getting this params and inside that file data. Okay, params file data. Let's save it. Okay, inside our file name, file URL and file type is there. Okay, so we have this like this. So now what we can do is let's import content from Nativebase because I'm using Nativebase here. You can check Nativebase and inside that let's create image import from React Native and inside that we can pass source as like this URI and copy it out then file URL. We have URL there. Okay, close this. Next we have to do something like styles here. That's flex one also for width we can import dimensions from React Native. Let's say width dimensions dot get window dot width, save it out, just copy this, do same for height, height and height, save it out. Then for resize mode, let's do cover, or we can say contain, save it out. Now go to this, you can see we are able to show that image in next page. This okay, sample PDF, it's PDF file, so that's why it's not showing an image. So for that we need to add a check here. What will be that check? That will be if fruits param dot file data dot file type equal to, or we can say, because there are many types of images file like png, jp, so like we can do whatever, includes image, okay, save it out. Okay, now you can see we are able to show the image file. Now let's start with the PDF, how we can show the PDF file. So for that, just go to React Native PDF here, this, just install that quickly. We already have fetch blob here, just copy this out here because I'm using yarn here, paste it, done. Okay, then npx pod install. Okay, iOS installation, nothing to do with installation, linking is automatical. And Android, we need to copy these files. If you are using RN 0.59.0 and above, you must have these files. Just copy that out, copied, and inside build.gradle, which is inside app folder, here inside this. I already have these. Note it down. If you don't have these, so paste it down there. Okay. If you don't have these files, you have to paste here. Otherwise, you will get error. I am saving it now. Next. Anything else? Nothing to do with it yet. Okay. Now save it out. Now let's running the project again in iOS. Will show on Android later also. Close this and close this. Close this out. Close this out. Now, same as this, copy it out. Now we can say move this. Now file type equal to application PDF, then we will show here. What we will show, just copy this out here, place with PDF. Okay, React Native PDF, we need to import it like this. I imported it. You can see here it is. And now PDF source will be like this: file, URL, style. Okay, everything is remove resize mode. Nothing else. Okay, fine. Let's save it out. Let me check. Images are still showing. Sample PDF is showing there. You can see this was sample PDF. Sample PDF here. Okay. Done. So let me check on Android also. So this was a tutorial on upload any file type to Firebase storage and get reference from real-time database into our application. So I hope you understand this. So let me check for Android once. Hope it works too, because it's working for iOS for both PDF and as well as images. So you can upload many files. Let me show you how you can. In document.picker, types all files. Click on that all file. You can see these are the files. All files like audio, CSV, docs, like plain text, PDF, zip, spreadsheets, video, audio, anything. You can check, lots of files are there. So we can upload that type of files easily by converting the path of that file to the base64, and we can put that base64 string to the Firebase storage. So what's next? So here it is, Android run successfully. Also you can see here's a list of the files we uploaded. Let's try new file to upload. Let's try untitled.png again. It should be after sample.pdf file. You can see it's there. Okay, and click on that. It's opening on the next page. Okay. On click of sample.pdf, you can see we are able to show that sample PDF. Untitled.png. Go back, sample.pdf. Okay, we are 5 files into our database. Let me delete 1, 2. I deleted 3 files. Now after refreshing, there should be 2 files. Let me refresh it. You can see 2 files are there now. Untitled.png, it's opening. Then sample.pdf. So friends, I hope you like my video. If you like it, please subscribe my channel and share with your friends. So let me know what type of tutorials you want from me. So thank you very much, friends. Take care. Bye.